With the release of iOS 14, this was our introduction to widgets, picture-in-picture, and so much more. But now, since this firmware update has been released for quite some time now, there's a lot more widgets that recently got released that really do enhance the overall experience. So in today's video, I'm gonna go ahead and share with you my top 10 favorite widgets that I used on my personal device to not just better personalize your phone entirely, but also unlock some really nifty, unique features that really does enhance your overall iPhone experience. So these are gonna be my top 10 favorite widgets. Let's get started. Now, surprisingly, these really useful ones are all shockingly free. For instance, this Google one, for example, actually gives us access to a really unique feature, and that is Google Lens. So we have access to four different shortcuts, but one of them is Google Lens. It's just a quick shortcut that's already innovated on the application, but it's basically what this allows you to do is scan an object, an image, doesn't matter what it is, like take for instance this microphone. Without entering anything or describing it, I can literally just scan it by just simply taking a photo of it. It's going to use Google's sorcery or whatever to identify the product, so I don't have to play the guessing game because this application will basically know exactly what it is and will tell me more information of this product. But like always, you can have access to the search bar, dictation, use Google's voice to quickly search something up, and you also have access to incognito, and you get some powerful tools. So gives you some powerful tools in a widget. Now, the default weather widget is okay and all, but I feel like it should at least give us additional information. Hey Weather is an awesome free to download app that gives us the information that's lacking. So from right here, you can see how the temperature is going to change throughout the day. But not only that, you can also see the next few days right there. So it gives us more information compared to the native one by Apple. Next up on our list is Spotify. And you don't have to be a premium member to actually use the new widgets. That's right, Spotify now has widget support, which will just display the last video clip or music, song, podcast, or whatever that you listen to. So you have quick access right there on your fingertips. And for instance, I like using Spotify primarily for listening to my podcast. So if there's a new episode, it will display it right there, or it will display the favorite playlist that you constantly find yourself listening to. Now in this next app, you don't have to subscribe, you could just hit that little X and it will just exit it. But the app itself is free to download and it's called Battery Widget. Battery Widget is pretty cool because it not only will display the battery life percentage of your device, but will also give you more useful information. Now, the iPhones with Face ID, of course, they don't have the ability to show you the battery life percentage, so unless you bring down your control center. This widget basically resolves this issue, as you can always visually see the battery life stats, but just by going through here, you can see that it shows you a bunch of different information everywhere from storage capacity. And yes, I know my unit is already full. I'm experimenting with something, don't worry about it. But it shows us all that right here, and yeah, eliminates the need to actually go into the control center. Widget Scanner is the name of this next widget, and I'm surprised this thing is free because it gives you access to a bunch of useful tools. So for instance, if we quickly add this to our homepage, unfortunately it's not customizable, but this layout, I think it's still fine. You could scan as a PDF, you could scan a receipt, you could add text to image, QR code, or barcode scanner. You have access to all that. And if we take this sheet of paper right here, this small document I just found from some type of manual, you could just scan it just like that, and it saves it all automatically on your device as soon as you hit next, and that's it. So if you constantly find yourself having to scan documents or receipts in general for tech purposes, this will be really nifty. Now if you like a widget that will actually show you the number of steps you have taken for the day, check out Pedometer Plus Plus. This app gives you multiple different widget styles to choose from, and depending on your tracking goal, it's gonna go from red and it'll go to green as soon as you come closer to your daily goal. So if you like seeing this type of stats, definitely do check out this app. Now if you like to add an invisible widget to your homepage, check out Tidwid. What you have to basically do to use this app is take a screenshot after you open up a blank page like so, when you put your device in wiggle mode. If we go back to the application itself, select a wallpaper of the screenshot that we took, go to these layouts and select whatever style you want certain section of the widget to look like. You have additional choices to choose from, and you could control everything from the color, the text size. It's really, you could really customize it.
But if we go ahead and hit the plus icon, let's go ahead and look for Tidwood, and then you have these widgets to choose from. So the one we created was one for the top. Let's go ahead and choose this middle one, add this one to our widget, and now you actually have the date as well as the number right there in the center of the display that follows the wallpaper of your device. And before I almost forget to fail to mention this, if you force press and you hit the little edit widget tab right here, this is where you could select the left, top, middle, left, and all that stuff right there to target a specific section. Dash dot dash is the name of this next widget, and this one allows you to not only select a specific image, but you can actually add text inside the image as well. And it's not that limited. You could change it if you want to move it to a side, center it, or even change the size entirely. But let's just go ahead and quickly save this one. And you can see you could create some more too, but let's just quickly add the one we just made. And here it is. So you still have the general three selections to choose from. Let's just add this one. And just like that, we have a custom image on our homepage. Now, Noted is a very useful app on its own, but now there actually is a widget support for it. But this widget is actually somewhat different because you have the three different choices to choose from, like always, but these two actually have like a little quick access to a record icon, a record action, I should say. So if we add this one, for example, and we just simply tap record, it's gonna immediately take us to a new note where you can still add text, but notice that it's actually recording right above at the same time. So this is perfect if you're in a classroom. You don't have to be subscribed to it. You could just hit exit and you're good. But this doesn't require a premium subscription or anything like that to unlock and use this feature, which is quite nice. Now, if you're keeping track of multiple packages that's being delivered to your house, check out this application. This one allows you to enter the tracking number and will automatically convert the tracking number to the shipper supplier. So you don't have to manually have to type in UPS or anything like that. So there is a widget page for this, but for reasons, I'm not going to go ahead and display any of my personal tracking numbers on my products. But if you're somebody who has multiple packages arriving, this is a great app to definitely check out. The app itself is also really useful because it also shows you the little map and such of the shipment of your current delivery stats.
And there we have it, folks. I'll be sure to have links to all these widgets in the description down below. So literally everything is just a click away. If you got some good use out of this video, I would greatly appreciate if you could not just only hit that like button, but also get subscribed because as I always cover the latest software tips and hardware. So if you're into that type of stuff, make sure you are subscribed because there's plenty more Apple content coming out soon. So in the meantime, if you own an Apple Watch or you recently picked one up, be sure to check out this video over here as I go through my 10 most important things to change in the settings of your new Apple Watch. And then that video over there, that's just a video that YouTube is recommending specifically for you. Feel free to watch either or. Again, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll catch you all in the next one. See ya.